From our expert speaker, I think who is going to rock the show is first speaker, Mrs. Vandana Raj, who is our who is a fashion designer and running our design studio called Vandana Raj Studio, Bengaluru. Okay, so now Vandana, I'm introducing Vandana. Okay.
Hello. I'm sorry, I was not able to unmute myself and I was waiting for the host to unmute me.
Gayatri, you can actually start Vandana introduction. I have already given the brief.
Yes, I heard and I was waiting someone to unmute me. I'm very sorry for that, Gage. It gives me a great pleasure to introduce such a wonderful speaker of today. Vandana Raj, a mother, a designer and an entrepreneur, a woman who believes in her passion and inner power. Born in a vibrant town of Amritsar, which is in Punjab, and graduated in arts and Kathak. Her journey begins as a typical homemaker who loved creating a warm environment for her family. While being a mother of three girls, she pursued fashion designing from the Vogue Institute of Fashion Technology and established a designer boutique for women in the year 2002. She formalized all her learning and experience under the banner called Vandana Raj. And her boutique is, a well-known boutique is known as in the name of the House of Vandana Raj. Vandana says, clothes are a shadow of oneself. It's a lovely tagline, Vandana. After her graduation, in no time, she gained immense popularity in the same field. She says, the rich culture of Patiala salwars, jutis, and colorful ethnic attire, couples of big fat tradition of our hometown, Amritsar, have been a lifelong inspiration for this designer, who also believes simplicity is the best way of living. She used delicate and intricate design, detailed texture following the traditional fabric, applique work with gorgeous embellishment in a vibrant and diverse color platter to add life to the soul. Vandana's work has been covered in Femina and other popular fashion magazines and daily newspapers as a woman whose success is attributed to her fit determination. Vandana Raj made her debut in the fashion ramp in Kinwa Fashion Week in 2012, which is one of the most prestigious fashion event in the country. And she launched the Kadambari collection fashion events in a prestigious fashion event which happens Bangalore Fashion Week in 2013. A significant contribution towards building a label and making her name on global platform resulted in her achieving the Undaunted Inspiring Women Award, an award by Karnataka Women Achievers Award in June 2018, and was also felicitated by the Rotary Club of Bangalore for her continuous effort and work. She ensures that the client is happy to wear a Vandana Raj outfit on their most special days as a bride or any other special occasion. Truly, her garments make the woman feel who is wearing it with the vibe and confident to say and feel, yes, my dream come true. It's a one breath introduction was of Vandana Raj. I hope I presented you well. And Vandana Raj, over to you. And we are all very eager to listen from you, Vandana.
Yeah, hello. Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you, Gayatri, for such an elaborate and beautiful introduction of mine. So, and before that, first of all, I would like to thank Kowei to give me the opportunity to, you know, talk about my journey in fashion and as well as, you know, to talk about the fashion, that how fashion can be a business opportunity for most of you who are there. So today I'm seeing a lot of students from different kind of institutes, fashion institutes are also there. So I hope that I should be able to give you the right frame of business plan. So just allow me to start my presentation. Are you people able to see my presentation? If you can just thumbs up also, it's fine to me. Perfect. Can you people hear me, see me clearly? Am I visible? Am I audible? Perfect. Okay, so as Gayatri already explained, so I don't have to explain you people. My name is Vandana, and this is already, Gayatri has explained about all these things. And yes, from the only I would like to add here is that from the homemaker, and today, like, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm a designer, I'm a healer. So I think on this journey, there was a lot of challenges and very interesting journey where I happened to got all these achievements. And thanks to all my surroundings and everything. And so before that, I would like to just tell you before I go ahead that if you have any questions on any of the slides, please write it down with you. And in the last, we will take the question and answers. Hope it's fine. Is it okay? Please thumbs up. So I like to have that visual because I'm a very visual person. So I would like that if I can have that kind of emotions, you know. Okay, so designing is not only fashion. So there are designing, which is like, there are different fields in the designing as well. So which is like some of them I have just mentioned here, textile design, graphic design, jewelry design and all that. And what is fashion? So let us understand, because everybody knows what is fashion, but still I would like to a little bit of a brief introduction of fashion. Is fashion is about showing your identity. You know, sometimes we get to know the people, how they dress up, how they wear clothes, how they wear colors. So it is the first thing people look at it to interpret who you are. Fashion is the form of clothing, accessories. It can be, you know, used by everyone, definitely. And it can also show people's culture. Fashion is about, this is like, I always feel that very personally, I believe in it, that fashion is about storytelling through the clothing. It's about stories behind them and the ones you create around them. So it's all about that, you know. So fashion is what you can carry. The fashion is about trends. Fashion is about whatever the new things are coming up in the society. What is fashion design? So fashion design is the application of design, clothing and accessories. So here I have got some kind of industry of this thing that we should know that where the fashion is going ahead now. So this slides are very important for even the students to understand that where the fashion industry is going. Like this is a little old, I have a thing because I have not taken the new one because I was not getting it properly, because anyways, I think it's in Wikipedia, everywhere it's available. But the whatever I have taken is here is the size in financial year 2019 was estimated to be a $67 billion. And expected to grow at 10% per annum, you know, every year. And the Western wear market is 52%, which is including of men and kids wear of the total market. And the ethnic wear, which is dominated by women's wear, is expected to grow at 8% per annum. And now also recent study also is almost the same. Maybe a little drop down has happened because of the last year COVID, but still I think it's coping up. Even though the costs have gone a little high because of all the situation, whatever happened with the China, but still the market is getting smoothened, you know, day by day. And what is the global impact on fashion industry? So the global impact on, according to the studies, you know, I have taken it from Wikipedia. There is a one website called, you people can go through this directly. I have given the link as well here. So for that studies, you know, it says that the total apparel market in India is calculated to be about rupees 20,000 crore, means $3.4 billion. The branded apparel market size is nearly 1/4 of this, or rupees 5,000 crore. Designer wear in turn covers nearly about 0.2% of the branded apparel market. So basically, you know, in 50s, 60s, if you know about fashion something, there was no branded awareness was there. So this particular awareness has started from mostly from 80s, you know, from 70s, some churidas and all that has been introduced. But in 80s, basically the branded thing, that the label thing has come up. So it was in early 80s when the first fashion store Revicent opened in Mumbai. So it's just a brief introduction about a little bit of a history of fashion. I would like to give it here. So what is the economic influence on fashion? So basically how we all are becoming so aware about our environment. So the economic imperative to spend now, think later, earlier it was there. But now actually today's consumer trends to be more mindful about consumption, looking for just enough and better, more durable options. In fact, we are looking for that, how can we can have something more durable. The people are, when buying also, they always think in those lines. And the people have become more conscious of the impact of their everyday consumption on the environment and society. And these initiatives are often described, the move, as sustainable fashion. And I think this is very, very famous nowadays, that how we can have a sustainable fashion. Okay, so how this is just a brief introduction about fashion in designing in India, that how the fashion is huge industry in India. With globalization, Indian fashion has got a wider platform to display their talents and introduce the sari to the world. Actually, sari was no one knew it earlier. That was introduced by Indians. And right from the traditional salwar kameez or saris to churidas, kurtis, semi-formals, all these things, you know, we have started very much a highly elegant and contemporary style of draping saris. Like nowadays with the trousers, you must have seen the designer saris, how it is coming. With the trousers, the people are draping the saris and all that. So those kind of innovations has been happening, and halter neck cuts and all that. So this is just the brief introduction that how fashion is so happening and sexy as well, and looks elegant as well. And so there are a couple of famous Indian designers which I would like to tell you, that these, like a lot of more, but I have just given a small example here, because if I'm going to talk about a fashion a lot, then my presentation needs at least 2 to 3 hours, and I don't have time more than 20 minutes. So I need to give you the right picture on fashion. So these are the designer, like Ritu Beri was the first Indian designer who presented her collection in Paris. And Reena Thaka was the designer who got the winner's award in Yuv Ratan Award. And so now I have given you a brief this thing, that how in the market the fashion is and how the history of the fashion. So let us understand that how, and then you must be thinking that how we can become a designer and who can become a designer. So in who, if I can say, anybody can become a designer who has a creative mind. So students, homemakers, business entrepreneurs, anyone who's interested or passionate about fashion. So I have written it some of the options that how the students can be a part of fashion institutes by writing the entrance exams. And they can also be also learn from online courses or workshops. There are plenty of good colleges for designing out there. So there are a lot of options are there right now, like 6 months course, 1 year course. Anybody wanted to have a degree for 3 years, they can always go for it. So it's not difficult at all to become a fashion designer today. And so if you want to start your own boutique, I think that would be very interesting for most of the fashion designers, girls who are already studying and passing out and thinking about it, that how we can take our label ahead. So I think this particular slide can help them out. Mm-hmm. So according to my experience of this 20 years, it's almost 2 decades I'm into this particular field. So I feel the first thing anybody would need it for the fashion is location, location, location. I always say 3 things are important. So which is location, 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 that where would you like to open up your label? And of course, the passion and dedication is very much required. You require a proper marketing plan. You require inventory, machinery. You need to have a proper team of designers, tailors, cutters, pattern makers, helpers, the artisans and the salespeople and quality managers. You need to have a proper business plan and investment set on the table. So let's understand that how the business plan would be. Hope I'm not too fast. I'm okay. You people are understanding. Can I get some emotion from you people, some smile or something, or okay, fine, perfect. Thank you so much. Right, so business plan. So business plan, I have taken a very small thing that what is required when you need to create a business plan. The business idea is very important, the first thing. Another thing is, like, it is not only on the fashion field, like any field which you wanted to run a business. So I'm just giving a brief idea on the business right now, that your why needs to be strong, because this is what I have learned and I have experienced in my whole entrepreneurship journey, that if you are not emotional to your business, then it is very difficult for you to create a vision. So it has to be emotional. And then you have to have a proper research in the market. Your mission, vision, and tagline has to be set before you even think about it to start the other things. So these are the base. These are the foundation which you need to put it on. You know, you have to have that foundation with you. And the marketing plan, the marketing analysis, which is important in any field or any particular a product or service you wanted to go ahead, you need to have that market analysis report. And your USP is very important. USP, I mean to say here, is a unique selling point, that what is the main thing which is, you know, you can attract your customers, you can attract the people towards you. And your operation planning and your positioning in the market is very, very important. So when I'm saying positioning is very important, is that what do you want in the proper market space? How do you want that you have to have your brand visibility and your selling plan and the collections? Yes, if it is a fashion, then you need to have proper idea into your mind that it should be Western, Indian, Indo-Western, ethnic, bridal, or any other, kids or men or anybody. Okay. And before that, I would like to give you, I hope it's interesting. Are you people getting some knowledge over there? Okay, right. So now I would like to tell you a small budgeting frame. I have made it for the people who really wanted to start immediately. So it's not very detailed. If you want detailed, then I would like to take a separate class of you people, which I need at least 2 hours to give you the proper budgeting detail of any of the business. But right now, again, time constraint, I don't want to take it so detailing, but still I think that will give you a proper idea that how this budgeting can help you out. So here I have taken the 4 major patterns. One is I have taken a label, you know, if you wanted to start your label, own brand. One, I have taken a retail investment budgeting. One, I have taken if you wanted to start a factory. And one is that nowadays, like it's in the too much, like now we are into that mode of automation and online. So that's the business plan. I have taken it here. So if you wanted to start your own brand or a boutique or, you know, a label of yours, initial investment, you require at least 25 lakhs to 50 lakhs. And the gross margin is 30% to 40%. It has to be there. Like your planning needs to be there in such a way that you need to have the gross margin of 30 to 45%. Then only you can have the net profit of 10 to 15%. Otherwise, it would be difficult. And retail is like if you wanted to open a showroom or something in the market, in the normal market, like for example, in Bangalore, if people know a lot of about Bangalore, that MG Road, Commercial Street, those are the markets where you wanted to have an initial investment will start. Again, depending upon, as I said, the previous slide, location. So it all depends that how much you wanted to spend on the interiors, on your other things. So it is 50 lakhs to 5 crore, gross margin 35 to 40%, net profit would be 15% to 20%. And if you wanted to start a factory, like you have a mindset, okay, fine, I need to do something which is very great and my other generations also can handle the things, you can always think about make a factory. So for the factory, the initial investment is 3 crores to 15 crores because the machines, what you are going to have it, that much it is going to cost. And the gross margin is 30 to 35%, net profit is again 10% to 15%. And the online platform, that is again up to the individual. That also a lot of huge it's a huge subject again, but here I have just taken it okay, 10 to 50 lakhs rupees investment, where you may or you may not invest. You can always tie up with your vendors and then you can have only the product directly selling from them. And then here also the gross margin needs to be have 30% to 35%. And the net profit is 15% to 25%. Hope that's fine. Is it okay? Everybody? Fine. So required inventory and the manpower. So what this is, again, I have taken a very a brief introduction here just to give you people the idea. So now I have taken a small studio that if you wanted to open a studio, what are you looking for? In that particular studio, I have bifurcated the cost into fixed cost and the monthly cost. So fixed cost I have taken because the interiors and all that is one time cost. Mannequins, if you buy, it's one time. Machinery, all those things, material stock varies. You know, I have written it in fixed, but it varies, you know. It again varies how you are going to buy those materials. And the monthly cost would be approximately like where you are hiring the designers, stylists, you are going to have store managers, marketing managers, and artisans, your professional cutters, your pattern makers, your tailors, so all those things. So all together, I think monthly expenses to start with a small budgeting, you need to have 3 to 5 lakhs rupees. And starting investment is approximately 12 to 15 lakhs. That I have given you a very, very small thing. But if you have a, now again, if you go back to my first slide, that if you have the idea, so the idea is very important, that where do you want it to go, then only these things all, you know, be in the place. Right. And then inventory required. So that is like a basic things like how do you have to bifurcate your client display section, your production section, your management office. So you have to have a place where these three things has to be considered. You know, it's not only ki client aaya, client attend kiya, and that's it. No, it has to be like everything has to be perfect. And while doing your interior designing and all that, that's very important that the three things has to be there in your mind. That's very important. This is a very important point. If anybody would like to write also, they can write. They should consider the three things, which is VAK. So VAK means visual, auditory, and kinesthetic. Means that your interior has to be like looking wise, it should be beautiful, you know. You should have a nice music or nice background where the person is entering and they will feel nice about it for the place. And definitely you should have the designing in such a way that the people should get connected emotionally, because fashion is all about emotions. You know, it is all about storytelling. Right. So now you must be thinking, okay, investment is done, plan is done. Now, how am I going to get the customers? That's the major important thing, right? So I assume that you may be having these questions in your mind. Who is your target audience and why? What are their needs and wants from your brand? How are you going to get their attention? How are you going to convince them to buy from you? What are the costs associated with these activities? Who are you competing with and how will you beat them? So these may be a small questions which I have given an answer also, that how are you going to connect with your right kind of a customers through the exhibitions, sales, fashion shows. Word of mouth is the best market when it comes to fashion. Like it's been 20 years today. Now, like my daughters, my girls are telling me to do the marketing. Believe me, 3 years before, you people would not have seen me in the market. You know, I was totally doing the word of mouth marketing. That's very powerful. And then coffee mornings and having networks with different business platforms, like how it is Coway, BNI, Rotary clubs, all these kind of platforms helps you to creating your network over there. Then you should have to create nowadays, like how the fashion trends are going. Instagram account is very, very important. So Instagram, Facebook is the best source of marketing today. Today is the highest source of marketing is the fashion, is the Facebook. And definitely the other social media, Pinterest, LinkedIn, Twitter, and etc. the most important in the fashion today is the collaboration with the influencers. So a lot of new designers who are coming up, they collaborate because when they don't have a budget to start with, so they always collaborate with influencers and other marketing brands. And the networking with the event managers, photographers, models, makeup artists, fashion stylists. So this network is very, very important. And this slide, if anybody would like to have the screenshot, they can always have a screenshot because that will help and most of them. And definitely you should have a relationship with your vendors and the wholesalers and the raw materials people, right? Is it okay? Is everybody fine with this? Okay, thanks. And okay, so now let's talk about the trends in fashion. So this slide I have purposely put in because I feel the sustainability and eco-friendly fashion is nowadays coming up in a big way. Like for example, now Adidas also, you know, has collecting marine plastics to converting them into the shoes. And like earlier, like Louis Vuitton and all that is killing the crocodiles and taking their skins and bags and making shoes, which was really torturing. But now the people are using vegan products, leather made from cactus plants, bamboo plants, banana plants. So that kind of a eco-friendly people are becoming. So this is a one idea I am giving it to young designers that they can even think about that sustainability and that how they can go into the trends. They can change the trends also, you know, if they want. So another thing is that it's just a little bit of a knowledge on the fashion luxury brands, which is Armani, Fendi, Versace, Hermes, Gucci. I think most of you people must be knowing about this. And some of the designers are, designers are like Indian designers, Indian brands are there, like even Manish Malhotra and Global Desi, Fab India, Sabyasachi. So no Soch, this is just the introduction of the brands. I think mostly people know it, but you must know it. So now the very important topic I'm coming up to, so which is that, okay, you have made the plan, you have everything set up, you know the budget, you have the budget, you have taken the loans, you have started the thing. Now, what are the skills required to do all that? That's really important, that I cannot become just a designer, or I cannot become just like that if I don't know as an owner, as a founder, that what are the skills required. The skills are required in fashion, in designing, is that you need to have some basic knowledge of the history and the culture of the fashion. You need to have the basic design sense, you know, where you can draw your human croquis and all that. The basic knowledge of pattern making, draping, all those things, you must know it, because when the new interns are coming to you also, like, so then if you also don't know, how you can train the other people. So it's very important to have the basic knowledge. And there are factories who can even tell you, there are class, they take special classes in the institutes there, where they tell you how to test the fabrics, what types of printings. So you people know the basics of this. And the textile industries, like, you people should know that the textile industries, export houses, mass manufacturing units, how are they working? The next part is creativity. That's very important for any fashion designer or any designing field, because unless you have the creativity, unless you have a right mind, right side of the mind activated, then it is very difficult to handle that side of the business. So you need to have the basic skills of AutoCAD, CorelDRAW, Photoshop, Lectra, all those things. See, it's not important that the founder or the owner or the fashion designer should know and do of its own. But even though, if you are hiring the people, if you know the basic knowledge, then you can write kind of a person you can hire. And then you should have the feeling of the identification of the fabric as well. So, okay, so now till here, I think I have given you the basics. So now I wanted to tell you that what are the opportunities in fashion industry? Like today you have passed out and either you wanted to become a business person, you wanted to start your label, or there are other opportunities as well. So this is also a very, very important slide. So which is, like, I have given that you can be a fashion consultant, you can be a stylist, you can be a lecturer, professor in institutes, and conduct workshops to train people. you can have retail, like the retail markets are there, or the shops are there. You can become a marketer over there. You can become a designer over there. You can become a visual merchandiser over there. You can be a graphic designer. You can be a fashion choreographer. You can be in designer into the arts. You know, so there are a lot of opportunity for a fashion designer to have. Now you can actually have the opportunity to be in the film industry. Like if you see now how many of our Indian designers are booming in film industry, like Ritu Kumar, Anamika Khanna. Anamika Khanna has recently done the Padmavati outfits. It's such a beautiful and gorgeous outfit that girl has done it. So you can be a designer of any heroines, you know, you can connect it with those kind of people. And also you have an opportunity to work design for the corporates. Now corporates also is becoming very conscious about the uniformity, and airlines also is coming up. Like Kingfisher has broken the all idea of Indian fashion. So how the air hostess used to look like, if you remember in the Kingfisher. So that is also a great opportunity. So before I go ahead, Pallavi, Gayatri, I have a time, another 5 to 10 minutes. Yeah. So it's quickly, only 2-3 slides more. So because it is so exciting, I don't want to miss it out. And I think I have covered almost everything here. And now I just wanted to briefly tell you that fashion workshops at Vanna Raj. So my philosophy, you know, whatever I have made it till now and showing it to you. So I just wanted to share my philosophy with you, that I always feel, and I think every girl should have this, that the fashion is not only clothes. It is, but also the way of life. It's not outward. It's more about inwards, you know. So fashion is to know the psychology of a person and their emotions and of their own self. So basically, you should know as a fashion designer that how you can understand the emotion of your customer. Because if you are dealing with women are very sensitive when it comes to clothes. Very, very sensitive. So we have to be, you know, understanding as a designer, as the founder, that how we can take up the women when it comes to fashion, and especially the bridals when they come to you. So you people should have this proper knowledge of psychology of a woman. And then we teach how you can change your life with just love and, you know, enjoying, like you should be passionate when you are creating something. You know, it should show into your body. It should show that emotions into your body. And the main important thing I always say is that I believe that the fashion and spirituality go hand in hand. Fashion is the outer lining of a person, and spirituality is the inner lining. And if we can able to balance our inner self and our outer self, becomes much more happier and more confident. So thank you so much. And so these are just the things you people can always follow me and see that what are the things we are doing it in fashion. And thank you so much, everybody. So I'm just stopping sharing.
Thank you, Vandana. Thank you very much. I think a few questions. We have some few questions. We can.